So this is the Blatchford Lake. It's a really nice storm pond. The city's done a really good job at finishing it here. As you can see, it feels very natural, and that's only going to increase over the years. It attracts a lot of birds. I think there's even still some Canada geese around that are on their way south. But we like to think that the same ones come back every year that are born here in the summer. So it's very active in the summer with all the birds. It's wonderful. So it's a beautiful space for us to come to. We feel very fortunate that we have it. I mean, one of the things that's most important about this neighborhood is the district energy system that the city built, has been developing. You can see kind of the heart of it in the background there. So that's where the heat pump is, and it's pumping the liquid from the earth, where it's heated by the earth that is warmed by the sun, and then pumped back through the neighborhood, that each house then uses that temperature to be able to heat and cool through heat pumps in each of the house.
That's Josh Culling, a resident of Blatchford, the largest planned carbon neutral community in North America. He wanted to live downtown, but he also wanted green spaces, and the quality and sustainability of the homes was very important to him. Still, at first, he was skeptical about having a heat pump.
Well, I think one of the things about our home that's special is the heating and cooling and how effective it is. In part, that's because of the double studded technology in the walls to make sure that it's really well insulated. The building envelope, it's all really well secured. Lots of insulation, but I think, you know, most importantly from a sustainability standpoint is the district energy system, which provides us the temperature to have heat in the winter and cold air in the summer. And it works fantastic. The first day we actually moved into our house, or took possession of it, it was a heat wave. And we walked into the house, and it was like walking into a walk-in freezer. It was astounding. I never have forgotten that moment. And the system itself has been incredibly reliable since then. We've experienced no problems. Hot in the winter, cool in the summer. It's been great.
Josh's home has double studded walls, passive certified windows, and more.
We have solar panels on a roof. We installed them when we moved in, when the roof was new. And it generates a lot of the electricity for our house. Very, very excited about it. We have an electric car, so the solar panels also power our car, which is just wild to think about, that our car is powered by the sun. But as far as like things that we can do right now to impact our carbon footprint, Blatchford has allowed us to reduce it significantly in ways that we couldn't have done on our own.
Blatchford is redefining what downtown living means.
There's actually a lot of space to hang out. Like, I think that if you have the opportunity to walk through the neighborhood, you will feel that it's a different experience. So it's designed for pedestrians and cyclists, so it's very easy to move through the neighborhood, for one. But also there are a lot of public spaces. So, you know, just off to my left, but by the old control tower, you've got, you know, an orchard, you've got a large grass area, you've got a wonderful park for younger kids, area for gardens, community gardens are there. There's a fire pit that's been built out by the city. So there's a lot of public areas for people to use. But I think the main area that all of us value the most is the stormwater pond.
When it's complete, 30,000 people will live, work, and learn in Blatchford in an area that would house just 8,000 people in the suburbs. Josh is excited about the possibilities as more people move in and as more and more mixed commercial development is added.
There's the reality, as I have said before, that there will be more people living here. And so more people lead to more opportunities. Perhaps one day when 30,000 people are here, a large number of residents will be able to actually work in their neighborhood. That would be an amazing dream. You can just feel it when you walk through the neighborhood. It has a different feel to it. It's hard to kind of pin it down to an experience. It doesn't feel foreign or strange. It feels comfortable. I think that, you know, if you want an anecdotal experience, like, the kids get the value of the density, because at Halloween, when they walk around, they can go half as far and get just as much candy, if not more, because there's so many more units in the neighborhood.
In this new kind of urban design, the townhomes in Blatchford are encouraged to add garage and basement suites. Josh had a different plan.
One of the things about this neighborhood is that, you know, many of the houses have basement suites. We didn't finish our basement as such because it is our living room area and coffee space. But our houses were built with wonderful outdoor amenities at the front. So you could imagine if you were a renter in here, you'd have great space for yourself as well. One of the things that's unique about this neighborhood is that there are many units that are being built with basement suites as well as garage suites. So you're then getting three living units on one parcel, which is just fantastic. Opens up a lot of opportunity for a lot of different people to live in this neighborhood.
Josh's home has an alley, but one of his favorite features of his home are the mews out front, a pedestrian-only brick space where kids play basketball, hang out, and learn to ride bikes. Blatchford began by building townhomes. Now there are condo townhomes available, a 90-unit rental building is underway, and even bungalow townhomes are coming soon. So we're starting to see more variety in the offerings and price points. People we spoke to are pleasantly surprised by the living experience, and nearly everyone mentions the light rail transit on site and the proximity to downtown, shopping, and much more as key features. In future episodes in our series on the largest planned carbon-neutral community, we'll talk to a builder, another family, and we'll look at some of the cool technology that Josh mentioned in this story. Learn more on our blog at greenenergyfutures.ca. For Green Energy Futures, I'm David Dodge.